Hello, friends. I have to say this here, you all, because it's the truth. God is saying in this hour that there are blessings that are going to come forth, but the only people who are going to be reaping the blessing are those who have been faithful, those who have been putting the word of God forth in their life. Don't set yourself up listening to these people preaching about prosperity and all of this other stuff, thinking that it's going to apply for you. It is according to your faith. It is according to your deeds. It is according to the work that you have put in, standing on the word of God, moving forth in the word of God, using what he has given you and being faithful to what he has given you, walking out boldly, taking the things that he is telling you right now in this hour that is for you, you know, not living your life in fear, not running from everything that is coming up against you, but standing, knowing that God's hand is going to come through. Those are the ones that are going to be rewarded. There is no reward for you if you're sitting down and you are comfortable and you're not doing anything to step out in the things that God is calling you to, that he is saying that is for you. You can't get mad, you know, if you end up going through another year and you didn't put forth. So I know that this is him, you know, having me to say this here, because it's going to be a lot of people hurt again. You know, they're not going to move forward in the things that they have been asking for because they don't have the faith. I was in a store the other day and I looked at the size of a mustard seed and I'm telling you, I was like, wow, that's all it takes. And we can't even do that, some of us. I am telling you, if you put forth the work and you stand on the word of God, watch and see what happens. But if you are, you know, allowing that negativity to fill you in and fill you up, you're going to keep reaping the same thing year after year. And that is not the will of God for nobody's life. And a lot of these people are preaching about prosperity and living a blessed, rich, filled, beautiful life, selling you a dream. But that's another story, because he has something for those people too. Speaking all these things that he didn't tell them to say, causing his people to further astray from what God has told us to do and what it's going to take to get to what he has for you. Make your choice on today. Either heed this word or I'm sorry. You know, I have to be honest. We weren't put here to sugarcoat. We have to tell you all the truth, because if we don't, on that day when we have to go up before him, we are held accountable. All leaders are held accountable when they don't stand and speak what God tells them to speak because of fear of people walking away and leaving. You go. But I'm going to rest at night. You know why? Because I'm going to tell you the truth. And my husband is going to tell you the truth. So I understand if you all have to go. I mean, I can't lie to y'all, because we want to see y'all prosper. It's no sense of sitting up here like some of these people are doing, telling these lies, and these people ain't getting nowhere. They just digging deeper in their sins and looking for something that's not available to them, because God is issuing out to you for what you have done according to your deeds. And the word of God says to the faithful, he will show himself faithful. Let me find that verse, because it's real. And that was David. David had said that. I need to find that verse, because it's real. And that is one of my favorite verses, but mighty funny now that I'm on the phone. I mean, now that I'm doing this recording, I can't remember it. But that's one of my favorite verses there. David did that. I think it's in 2 Chronicles or 1 Chronicles.
I need to write that down because that verse is always coming to me. I'm not going to hold the recording, y'all. I'm going to find the verse and I'm going to leave it down at the bottom. But, you know, it's real. The word of God is real. To my people out there who have testimonies, I mean, that you know that the word of God is real, encourage these people. I am telling you, I am a living, moving, breathing miracle testimony. It is God's hand that has me where I am. We told y'all testimony. My husband has been homeless. I have been homeless. I have been beaten. I have been molested. I have been there. But God had the final say. If we stand on his word, believe in what he speaks, and apply it to our life, you can see the manifestations. Y'all be blessed.